गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल पार्टिसिपेंट्स. गुड मॉर्निंग अभिषेक सर.
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
सो फॉर टुडे सेशन वी हैव विद अस डॉक्टर अभिषेक कुमार, अबोट सर्टिफाइड एजुकेटर. सर इज एन इन्वेस्टर, साइंटिस्ट एंड ऑल्सो इज एप्पल सर्टिफाइड and certified by Autodesk. His research interest includes computer graphics, motion picture science, digital media and IoT. His technical proficiency covered a wide range of topics in various digital art areas like image analysis, visual identity, layout, digital photography, motion graphics, 3D animation, visual effects and compositing. He has also interest in teaching and he looks forward to develop the courseware for various institutions and universities. For today's session, sir will be covering the topic visualization effects. So thank you so much, sir, for your valuable time. Can we proceed with our session?
Yeah, ma'am. So thank you, ma'am. Thanks for giving me opportunity to sharing my some of the knowledge to respected professors and research scholars pan India. And thanks again to NIT Raipur to giving me such a wonderful opportunity to have like integrate how the graphic design, or you can say the especially computer graphics, is a now a new era of you can say the demonstration or a presentation or a virtualizations when we're talking about the medical simulation industry itself. If we long time talking about animation, and if you're talking about somehow the design itself, people are thinking it's some kind of arts only. But now if you're talking about especially medical industry, for example, if we have to teach any scholars about, or the student about, 1 minute, just I'm sharing my screen first of all. Yeah, so now I think it's visible. So if you're talking about scholars or the student itself about how the human body will work, right? So in that regard, definitely, like Government of India having a several restrictions now, and even into the overseas also, foreign countries having several restrictions with respect to operating a human body in a live manner. So what is the options we having? With that regard, we can go ahead with a graphic design visualization itself, where we can create entire body into the computer graphics integrated itself, and then later on we can have simple showcase that animated, or you can say the simulation integrated like a virtual lab, to the scholars, to the students, or you can say the medical practitioners. Using that virtual lab, they can interactively get play with that particular, you can say the sessions, or you can say the laboratory, you can say the practice. So how these are working, that's why when ma'am has given us the opportunity, then I thought this is something that can be a little missing when we're talking about right now 21st century, specifically related to the computer science engineering. We are majorly focusing on new thrust area like a deep learning, machine learning, right? So these are a common, very common, you can see the research where pan India 70% research scholars are doing his or her PhD, either that should be correlated to the AI or a deep learning or a ML itself. So now how computer graphics could be a new, you can see the research thrust area also. So I'm going to discuss in detail. So hope my screen is visible. I'm switching it into the full screen mode. Just a minute. Okay, so now hope it's visible. So let us go to the next. Ma'am has already stated about me, I having a majorly vast experience about specifically computer graphics itself. And like if we're talking about the right now computer graphics, so it's now not a limited with respect to only line drawing algorithm, circle drawing algorithm, or you can say the OpenGL programming itself. Now somehow it's integrated with the virtual reality, augmented reality itself. And if you're talking about especially COVID-19 pandemic situation, while across the globe, entire university lab has been shut it down, somehow virtual reality, augmented reality integration into the teaching and learning, that has played a really very vital role to get, you can see the fill the gap between learners and the mentor or the professors itself. So I'm little skipping. Now I'm coming to the main. So definitely if you're talking about the computer graphics itself, right? So I had a little integrated computer graphics with the communication design itself. Because from last, if we're talking about 7 to 8 years itself, IIT Bombay and IIT Guwahati has initially, they had started communication design program, especially that's related to the animation design, and you can say the visual perceptions itself. So now, before starting such courses under the banner of IITs, people are thinking, okay, communication design is somehow an integration of fine arts only. What a use of computer science engineering about this terminology? But here, if you're talking about a communication design, it's a blended between the computer science as well as, you can see, a little integration of IoT also. And it's a complete, you can say, the mixer is commonly known as the HCI, human-computer interaction. So if you're talking about the human-computer interaction, HCI, communication design is only playing the vital role. So what exactly we are doing into the human-computer interaction? So what exactly we are doing? We are developing the relationship between viewers and a visual. And additionally, what adding over there in HCI, we can interact also, right, with that particular element. So if we are interacting, that is a part of a virtual reality, augmented reality, or you can say the immersive technology also. Now, one more keyword I had put it here, game, right? If you're talking about the game, I clearly remember, or maybe definitely in your childhood, when you are playing the game, maybe you're a mom and dad, when watching you are not reading the books, you are playing the game, definitely they may be worried. Why my kids is playing the game? It's a time to get learned. It should be get a good mark into the 10th, 12th graduation master itself, carry forward. But right now, if you're talking about the game, somehow specifically last 2013 itself, I had started to get work gamification, how we can integrate the gamification with teaching and learning. And somehow I have got a really very good feedback while using the Unity as well as the Unreal game engine we having at that time. It's into Unreal was into the some of the paid and commercial version, but from last 2.5 years or 2 years back, they had also given the Unreal engine as an open source, you can say, or the free version we can use. But commonly either you can use the Unreal game engine or you can use the Unity game engine also. So how earlier this game engine was only dedicated for making a games, right? So maybe car racing, maybe bike racing, maybe one person shooter, such kind of games. But now, especially during the COVID-19, I had a work for 2 or 3 projects also that integrated with one of my research collaborated for University of North South Wales, Australia itself, Vijay sir, and under the esteemed guidance of one more professor from the South Korea University. Now we are working together on a project where we can integrate the virtual reality, or you can say the gamification, into the teaching and learning especially. And while we're talking about the medical industry specifically, where we're having really very limitations to get operate the entire body. For example, if we're talking about how exactly maybe human birth is happening. So maybe on a blackboard or whiteboard, whatever you are doing, or some of the sketch or the graph itself, somehow teaching and guiding is really very tough. But while we are made entire animated data with respect to that particularly process, and then we played that video, you see, this is the visual, this is the video, how human birth is going to be happen. So accordingly, when the learners or the medical practitioners are watching that video, definitely their confidence level would be too much with respect to the common people, which they are only learning through the textbooks or notebooks or some of the, you can say, the online, not online, whiteboard or blackboard based teaching and learning. So how this can be get implemented? Today I had a little less time, but still I will try to give you not only the, you can say, the presentation or a PPTs, how the things can be done. Definitely do believe me, after completion of today's sessions, you having a more confidence how you can create a study elements also. Yeah, definitely in 1 day, in 2 hours, it's a really very challenge. But if you're having the interest also, I had a make a backup also, you can plan that, you can get join that course also. That has been developed by me long time back, and that will help you a lot while you are thinking about the graphic visualizations, graphic design engineering itself with respect to the medical pre-visualizations. Going to the next. If you're talking about the communication design, why I had a mention communication design? Maybe this is a tell FTP, while I do believe maybe 60% people from the specific core engineering background, but maybe some of the professors or the scholars, maybe from management background itself, maybe from the design background also. So I try to get the presentation little easier to everyone. So definitely the people who are from the engineering background, they can easily understand, but the people who are from the non-engineering background also, they can easily understand the thing. So I had mentioned one of the things, types of communication design. It's the sub part, you can say, of human computer interaction, HCI. So this is the one important thing, interaction design, right? So interaction design means what? While we are able to interact with a 3D element. While we are talking about the movies like Iron Man, and you can say the Marvel series itself, where we are able to see Tony Stark are playing with like a quantum energy. He is playing with 3D elements also. Whatever he is giving the command from their fingers, accordingly, everything is going to be changed. That is somehow the sci-fi visuals now, but that all things are now true. We can also do the same entire thing using the virtual reality and augmented reality, or you can say the immersive technology also, right? So for this one thing, what a major, you can see the element you should be get identify. You should be having a good concept of graphic design. Now, why I mentioned the graphic design? Now, especially if you're talking about the graphic design, so one new terminology you are nowadays hearing, UX and UI itself, right? What is exactly UX and UI? How your application could be more convenient for the user? But end of the day, if you're talking about the UX and UI design, somehow you should be having a really very good concept clear about the graphic design. Then only you can able to draw a good, like you can say, the thumbnails, or you can say the logos, which can be a beautifully give a psychological impact to the users. Okay, this one I can may belongs to this one use. Then the data design visualization. Also, this is a really very very important. And last one is the 3D design visualization. So today we are majorly focusing into the 3D design visualization and interaction design. Moving to the next, the main agenda of today's session: virtual reality. I had put it one of the sphere, you can say, technical terminology with respect to the computer science engineering guy. And one that sphere, one wrapper of image, multimedia image has been get wrapped it off. Why had I put it multimedia with respect to the virtual reality? If you're talking about a long dash back, definitely in our computer science engineering, one of the paper, multimedia tools and application. While in the multimedia tools and applications, we are talking about, graphic design, we are talking about the 2D animations, 3D animations, we are talking about how we can do a good layout, how we can present our content in a best way in front of the audience itself, right? So these are something which are a commonly part of multimedia, where we are using the text, where we are using the visuals, right? And where we are using the audio, sometimes we are blending all three to give the good presentation. But now the new terminology is here, virtual reality. So again, there is two keyword here. We're dividing the virtual reality. There is one space between the same. Reality in a virtual way, right? So reality in virtual way means what? End of the day, virtually, we are going to create an entire scene. We are going to create a free, like a background. We are giving a CGI integrated, computer graphics integrated simulation place where that will give us a look of a reality. So this is a very layman term. You can understand now how or what exactly we are doing into the virtual reality. Now I'm giving little more beef here. So especially like this one entire FDP is dedicated related to medical pre-visualization, or you can say the medical practitioner, or how we can integrate computer science engineering or specifically engineering with respect to the medical, how we can interdisciplinarily do the research to get our like Indian medical industry into the more height, more richer. So here you can see the, some of the examples. Just I'm little scaling this one. So just let us delete. Already we had a get discuss about the same. So now it's a more clear and visible with us. So here you can see some of the handle device the guy had captured, some of the headset he has captured over there. And accordingly, here you can see the visualizations coming in between, right? So what exactly he is doing here, if you're talking about this one area itself, right? So this one controller, you can see these both are controller. This controller, you can see the same in a CGI we had given how your hand would be get moved accordingly. This one CGI element would be get it moved. And here you can see we are putting some smoke. So get it, check it out how maybe exactly the fire results is working or not. So this is entire simulation system. So CGI, this is not a real, but this will give you us the real look. If such kind of problem will happen, how we can troubleshoot that kind of challenges over there, right? So this is somehow related to the engineering. Now I'm deleting this one up first. And now if we especially talking about the medical itself, the second image here we having, I'm little scaling, right? The second image here we having, so here you can get check it out. 1 minute, I think my screen is visible or not, I'm checking. Yes, it's available, thank you. Okay, coming back. So now here you can see, for example, here if we have to talk about a human bone structure, how the bone structure is working, yeah, definitely We have invested several skeletons also, which we can buy from the particularly place, and we can get a understand about the skeleton. But if we're talking about the heart, how exactly heart is going to be pumped? How exactly heart is going to be operated? Or simply, if you're talking about the COVID, one of the most, you can say, the biggest disaster right now, while the people are hearing about this keyword of COVID itself, at that time, several people may be not feeling good also. So how the COVID virus is going to be given up? So definitely that virus is not visible. But when it's a time to get present about the reactions and chain, again, we require the computer graphics to get demonstrate about the same COVID process, how that a virus is going to be spread between one human to two second human itself. So again, the graphic design visualizations is playing a really very vital role while we are talking about the medical industry itself, right? Again, here you can get, check it out. Virtual reality, here for example, now virtual reality, again, we are adding more sense over there, right? Because somehow when we are keeping the head mounted display itself, at that time, we are only able to watch. So whatever things are going over there, accordingly, we are feeling some side effect, or you can say, accordingly, we are feeling that kind of virtual, maybe fire things over there. But right now, when we're talking about somehow virtual reality, again, we are integrated with real life simulators also. Maybe here, this is a virtual headset, is lady has been kept, and here we had kept one of the spider, 3D, real spider, and then we had put that spider in hand. So this one entire sensor is simulated with HMD. So it's looking like, okay, well, while you are touching these things, accordingly, that CGI element is also responding. So this is the one more integrations file, we can say the HCI, we had a more integrated with a virtual reality simulation systems itself, right? Okay, while we are talking about the technology, definitely each and every technology having the advantages and disadvantages both. So if we're talking about the both things over there, so virtual reality is a help you to feel virtual manner about the realistic world. Second thing is what it enable user to explore places. For example, I'm giving you one example. While previously joining the JNDMTV University, I was associated as an assistant professor in Banaras Hindu University itself, Uttar Pradesh. So at that time, we had written one proposal, like a very commonly one of the challenges going on over there for Ayodhya Ram Mandir itself. So what we had proposed to Government of India, okay, how much time it's taking for the dispute and how much time it will take to get a result from the Honorable Court itself. Why not let us create an entire Ram Mandir into the CGI industry? On that respect, I had given the proposal. Somehow, some good response also I had received. But during the time of COVID-19 itself, last year, now government has approved, court has given the permission to get a real structure of the same. So somehow now that product hasn't get dropped down. But still, simply think about maybe the heritage itself. Several heritage now they are not existing. But if we're talking about to get demonstrate about that heritage, using the virtual reality, we can explore that places within sitting at one place itself. Now, next we are talking about the artificial intelligence itself. Then we can get integrated the IoT devices also, sensors also with integrations of the virtual reality. So how the simulations is going on accordingly, we are generating the physical effects also. And that will help us to get feeling the more realistic result over there. The disadvantage is what the equipment used into the virtual reality are very, very expensive itself, right? Specifically, if you're talking about the VR, right now we are working on one project. I will demonstrate about that project also in today's session. So we are using the Microsoft HoloLens. So Microsoft HoloLens cost is coming somehow 2.5 lakh. But if you're talking about the Microsoft HoloLens 2, somehow in India, it's not available and we had a procured, but that cost is went around 5.5 lakhs rupees itself. And again, it's a consist of complex technology. So we can't hand over that technology to common students or the medical practitioner who are being not well versed about that technology. Because if any challenge, any problem happens, a big loss would be we will face over there. Third part, in a virtual reality environment, we can't move by own like a real world. But this one statement, what I had mentioned, it's a depend upon a particular that project, how precise we had completed that project. So with respect to that project, the proficiency, we can give 100% interaction result. But right now, if we're talking about STC, handheld devices itself, somehow 60 to 70% we are giving the same interactions, but somehow more research is going on because somehow we are getting little latency over there also. So whatever operations we are doing with respect to that, we should be having the good PC itself to get compute that entire simulation into the interactive and real life stages also. These are some of the applications of virtual reality and augmented reality. So especially if you're talking about this image, right? So this one image is virtual reality image or augmented reality image. I had mentioned applications of virtual reality. Can anyone tell me here, this is the augmented reality or virtual reality? Then I will tell you the difference between the augmented reality and virtual reality. What? Anyone can put the input into the chat box? Okay, I think Kirti, Karesh, ma'am. Okay. Full screen your slide. Okay, thank you, thank you. I have not checked the slide. I'm switching, 1 minute. Start. Fine. Now I think it's into the full screen mode. I'm going. Yeah. Virtual reality. Dr. Aram sir has mentioned virtual reality. Venkateshan Prasanna sir has also mentioned about the virtual reality. Okay, virtual sir has mentioned. He is a very smart. He has not mentioned the reality keyword. Virtual only sir has a mentions over here, right? So technically it's a virtual only, but it's not a virtual reality, core virtual reality. What's the difference between virtual reality and augmented reality? Somehow if you're talking about the virtual reality, that means we are going inside to the 3D world, right? But here what happening, using the cell phone, using the tablet, we are keeping the 3D element, 3D assets with there. So this is the example of augmented reality, right? Not virtual reality. I'm giving more brief detail about the virtual reality, augmented reality, and immersive technology all about today sessions only, right? So let us move to the next. Yeah, applications of virtual reality. If you're talking about the applications of virtual reality, now all places, it's a going, you can say the blast. I clearly remember when I was given an interview itself, I'm not going to disclose that is the India's top 10 university itself. Then at that time, when I did what is the research area, then in 2012 itself, animation design and game technology. Then they said, what a use of animation design and game technology with respect to the computer science engineering. This is nothing. These are art people are doing itself. But yeah, if we blending the animation and a game technology, then only emergence of virtual reality came into the system. Now during the COVID-19 pandemic, now while we are stuck into our home, now we are understanding how the virtual reality or the augmented reality coming to the system while our kids are somehow installing the applications of a Google AR applications also. Simply you can take the snap accordingly, a lot of visuals are coming. While we are integrating virtual reality, augmented reality into the teaching and learning, somehow the really very good result we are getting with respect to the learner engagement also, right? So we can integrate the virtual reality, augmented reality to the automotive industry, healthcare. Healthcare, retail, tourism, real estate, architecture, L&D, recruitment also. This is a new thing. I will explore how recruitment is going on into the some of the foreign university itself. Yeah, definitely in India also we are trying, but due to the little less bandwidth, somehow we are not able to live stream the VR integration interactive recruitment process, entertainment. So earlier, this one virtual reality only belongs to the entertainment. People are thinking, why we have to go with virtual reality? Only entertainment purpose, and there is no any use of VR for the others. Educations also. So how these things are implementing, I'm going to share 101. Okay, so again, if we are going with the application right now, sports, art and design, event conference, well-being, charity, marketing, recreation, military, news and journalism. So you can say the entire STEM field, science, technology, engineering, management, all places right now we can integrate the VR. Even for the training of cricket, even for the training of basketball, right now we are working on a project under the Ministry of Australia itself. So they had given one small funded project on that. We are creating a complete VR integrated sports simulation system where people can get done entire practice within one big size of room. When they are getting a good points over there, then only we are giving the facility to go exactly into the real place itself to get performed the same, right? So these are, you can say, the automotive industry, some of the examples, healthcare, like here, how you can operate the human body within the seizures. So these are the virtually we can get interact with the same, right? Already we had a get discussed, so little I'm skipping the things. Retail business, So for example, right now we can give one of the very common example of Lenskart, where you can get capture your face over there, and later on, according to your face, automatically they are recommending several spectacles, and whatever spectacles they are giving a good look, accordingly you can buy that spectacles over there. So in a retail also, we are integrating the VR again. So sorry for interruption. Some background noise was coming, right? So moving to the next, after retail, we are talking about the tourism. Like earlier also, I had get stated, in a tourism, we can simply sit at one place and we can enjoy the entire Rome. Even one of the projects, you can check it out in after the completion of session. If you want to go and check it out, what Titanic has been get fell down. So entire Titanic has been get recreated into the 3D, where each and every room, all the minor detail with the nameplate, they had put it over there. And you can get interact using the HMD, and you can feel, you can watch going inside and walking inside the Titanic ship itself also. So these are some of the integrations right now into the all field. Real estate also, right now, every people having one dream home requirement. So simple thing, when you're talking about the dream home itself, at that time, before buying your dream home, you are able to visit how after 3 years completion of that entire project, how your room will look like. Definitely you can give more input. Okay, no, this one wall is not looking good. This one wall should be a little right-hand side or left-hand side, or the color is not good. Accordingly, we can change the color virtually, and later on, if everything is get it locked, then we can get a start working into the real world, right? So you can save your money also over there. Whatever your requirement, accordingly, the constructor company, they can also understand what exactly your requirement, and then you can carry forward. So these are some things which you can integrate the virtual reality into the architecture industry also, right? Learning and development, like we are talking about, we will give you some more example visuals, then that would be help you a lot to get understand how in a learning and development, especially related to the intelligent health computing, it would be really a boon for the learners during the COVID-19 pandemic time. While entire physical laboratory has been getting closed, using the VR, here we can get interact with the learners also. Fine. So recruitment, like here you can see somehow the interactive things is going on. So right now, your banking groups has been implemented VR to get evaluate graduate in 2017 itself. In India, Monica Mitra, ma'am, your mic is unmuted. Monica Mitra, ma'am.
Miss Monica Mitra, please, will you mute your mic, please?
Okay, thanks, sir. Thanks, ma'am. Okay, so this is one of the very small examples. So right now in recruitment, only 0.001% people are using the VR. So maybe definitely if some technology has invented slightly, it would become in our country also, and slowly integration would be go ahead, right? Education, already we had get it discussed. Now this one, we are talking about the sports. So entire with respect to the STC handle devices, how you are firing accordingly, you are getting the points, and if you are getting 10 out of 10 points each and every time, then only now people are giving the real, you can say, the gun to get fired or other sports. So right now NBA, NFL, all they are working for the sporting events. Right now, earlier if you're talking about the EA Sports, they are the company who are making the several games. So now ER Sports is giving a real life virtual simulators also, where we can train entire the sports or the athletes into the VR environment, and later on, if they are performing well, accordingly, we can have promote them to the real set itself. Fine. So art and design, like we had a talk about the well-beingness, especially if you're talking about right now, COVID situation, several people maybe went with a little depression. So yoga, meditations are playing a really very vital role to get rejuvenate their body. But while we are talking about the yoga, but sometimes several people are maybe want to go and explore several new places. In that manner, they are feeling more rejuvenated, or you can say the energized. So in that manner also, now several recreated. Now, if you're talking about a movie, Avatar itself. So how beautiful colors they had put it over there to get created a fully greenery environment over there. So same kind of environment, if we are keeping ourselves inside of river or a mountain, sometimes we are feeling ourselves more positiveness. So during the COVID-19, again, we are stuck into our home. So such environment, we are giving that kind of natural feeling using the virtual reality. And we had a get a research feedback also, people who are engaging themselves with integration of virtual reality integrations, they having a more cure while they are into their own home also. I'm also working on one of the research paper itself in integrations of well-being using the virtual reality. So somehow the research survey is also going on. So definitely very soon when the paper will accept it, definitely that would be available to everyone to get learned how that could be get available, how we can integrate the VR systems to get regenerate the human itself. Events and conferences also, right now these are the one of the example, but yeah, again, as I had tell you, the VR headset, even if you are going with Oculus headsets also, you have to on average pay up to 50,000 rupees for one headset. So somehow it's a little expensive, but yeah, maybe when the technology would be get integrated and slowly price would be also get fallen down. Because if I'm clearly remember, for example, if you're talking about the touch screen cell phone around 10 years back, it's a costing around 70 to 80,000. But right now in a 5,000 also, we having the same big size 5-inch or 6-inch screen in our hand, right? So we having technology cost always going down and down and down. So maybe after 5-6 years, we can expect the VR headset cost would be 10,000. So that could be commonly available for a mid, like income people also. These are the one more example of well-being in virtual reality. Marketing and promotions. We are in military sports. So here you can get the kit out for a training. We are using all the sensors. Kinect device also we are using for the same, right? So with a Kinect device, they are sensing how much far, how much close, accordingly the G-depth technology, you can say the G-depth, using the G-depth, we can analyze how much object is a farther or a closer, accordingly we can get calculate the result of the, you can say the performance itself also. So these are some inputs in several fields we can go ahead. About virtual reality. So now this is a broad one of the overview how virtual reality is a majorly integrating with all the like a field, either it's the science, technology, or engineering or management. Now we are talking about one of the project on which we are right now working. That's the project I. So project I is why. So let us switch to the second NIT rack or why. So hope my screen is visible again. Let us switch strap. 1 minute. Fine. So hope please can anyone confirm? Yeah, it's a visible. I'm watching in third screen. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
So let us. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Let us switch to the next project I with the continuity of the last session. So project I is what? So now I'm looking little input from you all. Can anyone guess what is the project I? Any guess, either answer would be true or false. Only two options is here. Please, you can type into the chat box also. Because all we are professors and definitely we are feeling really very upset when we are talking with a student and students are not responding. So at least we can use the chat box also if you are not comfortable in unmuting and talk right now. It can be the I, Hyundai i10, iMovie, I means India. Any guess? Thought from the I, Devika, Dev, so ma'am, any more?
I myself, weaving and visualizing in various circumstances and situations.
Great, sir. You are very close to the identification of I terminology which I had used here. Any more input?
Thank you,
any
sir.
Any more? Sir, any more? And I guess imagine intelligent in reality. Govind Swami sir, you are you had scored 99.99% closer to the right answer, sir. Okay, so it's what exactly what Govind Swami sir has said. Intelligent in reality. So somehow we can make little simplifier. Reimagining reality. Lot of eyes are here. And eyes play a really very vital role. Eyes only play the important role in a computer graphics engineering. Because yeah, somehow without eye, only 10 to 15% we can sense about the virtualization. Because we having some of the sensor recording, we can imagine about the colors also after closing our eye also. But a real feeling, if you want to go ahead, then eye is very, very important. So reimagining reality, this is. So let us see one example, how in a medical technology, it's playing a really very vital role. Actually, we are connected with Google. So I think in a Google we having a no option to share the audio also. So what I can do, there is a one background audio also, but I will state verbally, so that problem would be automatically get resolved. Because in Zoom and WebEx that facility, but can anyone put a light on this? I think as per my knowledge in Google, we having no option to share the audio. Anyone having any idea? Any new upgradation happen? If not, okay, let us play. So this is one of the terminology, chemotherapy, right? Let us come back. So chemotherapy is the one of the very common terminology when we're talking about the cancer.
Chemotherapy.
Right? So
chemotherapy is one of the modalities used in
for example, here maybe some of having not much idea about a medical terminology, but do believe me, just watch this one video, and after watching this one video, you having the 100% clear idea, not 100% we can say, because we are an engineering background people maximum, so always 99.99%, it you would be get clear about the chemotherapy, how is going ahead. So let us play the same.
The patient, often in conjunction with surgery and radiation therapy, cells in the body grow and divide according to the normal cell cycle, which is controlled by the nucleus. The genetic material or DNA inside the nucleus contains the information necessary to exist.
Now here you can see, I'm just making one small pause. So here you can see the selections of DNA. So what with respect to the color code we had put it, when your DNA is active, working, then it's a colorful. When DNA, or you can say, the cells is going to be die, then the color is converting to the grayscale. Have looked the same.
Execute this process. If the DNA in the nucleus gets damaged, it either repairs itself.
Right, so here you can see, just we had put it a gray color, so it's a damaged cell. So how intelligently using this one, a visual, now learner can easily understand how exactly the DNA role into the chemotherapy, how the chemotherapy process is going
it
ahead.
Let us
go ahead.
Or sends instruction to the cell to die. In the case of cancer, the portion of the DNA that controls cell division is altered, resulting in the DNA unable to repair itself or instruct the cell to die. This causes the cell to grow and divide uncontrollably, creating multiple copies of itself called cancer cells, which displace normal cells to form a tumor. As the tumor increases in size, it also begins to develop its own blood supply, as cancer cells do not adhere to each other very well compared to normal cells. They tend to break away and enter the nearest blood vessel, thereby spreading to other parts of the body in a process known as metastasis. Other common metastatic sites include the lungs, liver, bone, and brain. Metastasis may also occur through the lymphatic system, with cancer cells entering the
I'm little forwarding ahead because we're having a less time and lot of thing, even what were virtualizations you are watching here. I will try to give on a smaller practical demonstrations also how this thing can be get made up using the 3D application today only. So I'm little carry forwarding the scene because now you're having the enough idea after watching the video till here. For example, if you're talking about the how you can get fuse the cancer cells itself, it's a really very challenge. But to get demonstrate to the audience, or you can say the medical practitioners or learner, but while you are watching this one a video and parallelly you are demonstrating to them, it's a really very easy to get understand them how exactly body is going to be performed and how we can get troubleshoot the challenges while we are talking about the chemotherapy itself also, right? So these are how you can fuse and inject the things over there, right? So this is the one example.
One, adequate rest. Two, nutritious diet. Three, medication to minimize the side effects.
Right? So hope after watching this one video, I do believe 99%, now you're having a better idea how exactly chemotherapy process is going on. While we are not doctors, right? But still we are able to understand how the things is going on. So while we are integrating the computer graphics integration into the medical field and using this terminology, if we are presenting, if we are connecting with our audience, if we are connecting with our students, definitely the learner engagement ratio would be get up. A second example, just I am sharing with you. This is an example of nose surgery, right? Let us carry forward. So now here you can get check it out. This one nose is not straight. So if you're talking about a surgery, 70% time if you're talking about the facial surgery, not 70, more than 80 to 85% for enhancement of beauty, we are going with the facial surgery itself. Sometime with some of the disaster or some of the, you can say the problem only, we are going with the surgery only during the time of accidental case and all. But if you're going ahead with the statistics analysis about the face surgery itself, 70 to 75% of surgery is related to the face is only going for enhancement of a beauty, or you can say the makeup only, right? So here the nose is not a straight, so nose require a straight and little bended also. So how the surgery is going to be happen? After watching this one visual presentation, as an engineering or a management background also, you're having enough idea how the surgery will go ahead. So while we are integrated these things into the teaching and learning itself, at that time, while the medical practitioners is going to the OT, doctors going to the OT, operation theater, their hand would be less safe first time also, because they're having a better idea how to operation to be get it done. And while we are integrating the virtual reality, because here what's the problem in this one videos, these are the self-explanatory videos. But if you want to get interact with this video, that is missing. So how the interactions is happening, we are going ahead. So let us first watch this one. So these are the noses little are bended. From a front also, here you can see the nose is bended. So how we can get operate the nose to get the, you can say the close to the perfect shape over here. So first of all, definitely the scar, the patches, the annulment, these are the normal procedure we are going ahead. So here you can get check it out. These are the muscle bone, first of all. So you should be need to be fused that one area. Sensation should not be over there. Then only people can go for the operations, right? Because if the sense would be over there, definitely pain would be too much high and operation cannot be get it done. So here you can get check it out. We had put this one area into the gray color. So this one sense is totally dead now. So easily now operation can be go ahead. So how you can first of all get a spacing between the nose, then you can put a cut over there, right? So while you do believe me, when you're going with this interactive presentation or interactive, you can say the demonstration, while you are demonstrating the biomedical engineering practitioner student or a core medical students at that time, it's really very easy to get demonstrate them how the operations could be getting done. So for alignment, then later on some patches is required over there, then definitely stitch will go ahead and now the nose into the straight condition. While it's and everything is fine, then stitches is required over there. So now properly they are doing the stitches. After stitches, again, they will check it out. If for more details, if a more alignment, we need to get check it out. We need to get rework on that, right? Here you can get check it out. Then let us tighten it because no required to be straightened over there. Okay, so here you can see the final result. And yeah, definitely some more for supporting. We are putting some of the support element and final patch over there to, yeah, so to get more cure faster over there. So in this one manner, the entire nose surgery will be get it completed. So this is the before and after scene over here. So you can see earlier the result is here. Now after nose surgery, the result is over here. But the majorly problem is what here, if real lab, when you will operate this one thing, definitely you would be more confident, right? But after watching the video, 50% you are confident over there, not more than that. So while I was working into the pre-research report, definitely, it's around 86 country survey report itself. So we came to know even commonly it's a 20% if we are only hearing, that data is going to be saved in our brain hard disk. 30% if we are watching, and up to 90% when we are doing the practice, right? So again, if we are doing the practice itself, so this is some of the project which we are working with the collaborations of doctors and scientists and professors from the BHU, SCPGI Lucknow, UNSW Australia, UPM Malaysia itself. This is a joint collaboration we had done some research report. And if you're talking about the same, so what are things we can get integrated? So last terminology with that mentioned over there, we can learn more than 90% if we are doing. That's why laboratory is important for the medical. But again, the challenge is for, so LVD is what exactly I'm going to demonstrate. So LVD is the one of the solution which is helping the people while entire physical lab is closed worldwide, right? So solution is what? Solution is I, Project I. What is Project I? Learn and simulate through I technology. What that technology? I technology is immersive technology. So immersion with technology is known as the immersive technology. What exactly immersive technology? Immersive technology is the blend of the 360 virtual reality, augmented reality, mixed reality, and extended reality videos. Now, if you're commonly talking about the VR, AR, MR, and XR, what this terminology is, so this is one of the very good example. In one single image, I am trying to demonstrate with you. This is the reality, live image. Second is the mixed reality. So first of all, reality means real picture. Virtuality means these are the CGI integrated environment. When we are blending the reality and virtuality, then it's terminology called the mixed reality. Now, what is the augmented reality? I had put it into the bottom, augmented reality and augmented virtuality. Augmented reality means what? The dinosaur which you are seeing. So using the cell phone or the tablet, we are scanning some data. So for augmented reality, the device is mandated. So what you are doing in augmented reality, you are calling 3D element into the real environment. Just carefully read my words. What I'm telling, you are calling 3D data, right? 3D computer graphics data to the real world. And you are watching through the cell phone or the tablet. But in a virtual reality, we are going inside to the virtual environment, CGI environment, and then we are interacting with the CGI integrated element. So this is the difference between the augmented reality and virtual reality. When we're talking about the blending of a real environment, virtual environment, both, then it's known as the mixed reality or the MR, you can say, right? So if the basic concept is clear with you, virtual reality, augmented reality. Now, if you're talking about the VR and AR, right now, definitely, these are rapidly changing into the everyday normal lives also, this technology right now. Okay, so what exactly, if you're talking about the immersive technology, when we are integrated into especially medical field, then somehow we are getting a 75 to 90% retention ratio from the medical practitioner or the doctor itself. Here is one of the example I'm sharing. This is one of the projects on which still we are continuing our work. For example, if you're talking about the 1.MZ, right, one of the applications from where you can buy the medicine, right? So right now what we are doing, the agenda of this one of project, we are get connected with more than 1,000 plus doctors pan India in a first phase. Now we're having more than 8,000 plus doctors connected with us. What we are doing, if we're talking about one medicine, for example, medicine, name is the paracetamol, common terminology, or that medicine, maybe one sumo medicine name, or the calpol medicine name, or we can say some other crocin medicine name. So commonly these are the correlated with each other. For a fever, we are utilizing this thing. But if you're talking about the human body, definitely the human body of Tamil Nadu people will not the same thing with respect to the Jammu Kashmir people. Why I'm telling this one statement? Because in a Jammu Kashmir, in a month of December itself, too much cold over there. But in a Tamil Nadu, not that much cold over there, hot environment over there. While we are talking about the Bangalore, moderate environment each and every time. So definitely how for each and every kind of, you can say the environment or the people who are living into the cold place, hot place, same medicine will work. Sometimes 70% that will work. But if we are adding more, you can say the supplement medicine, that will work more. So what we are doing, for example, we are collecting all the data from the medical hospital. If doctor has recommended ABCD medicine, how many days, again, patient is came, again, how many days patient is came. So with respect to that data, if patient is coming two times, three times, after three times, he is not coming, that means what? Either he is cured or he went off. Two conditions only, algorithm, one value or zero value. One value means what? He is cured, he is not coming. Zero value means what? Maybe he is off. That's why he is not coming. So with respect to the predictions of this one data, we are analyzing after 3 dose, 4 dose, this one is working in Chennai region or Hyderabad region. So specifically with particularly that region, we are generating one of the apps where we can put our age, our environment, what is the weather conditions over there, temperature conditions over there, what is your prior symptoms over there. You put all the data, hit the enter. Artificial intelligence will calculate all the calculations over there and he will directly recommend you 4 medicines name over there. That medicines you can simply buy from the several websites, Pan India we have it. So you can buy from there. So within a home, without a meeting with a doctor, you can get a perfect medicine with respect to your particular specific zone itself also. Yeah, definitely that would be a really, really big challenge. Who are making doctor as an a business, right? Not like as an a person itself or profession itself. So definitely the business would be getting hampered. But as an a patient, if you're talking about this, when this would be completely executed, definitely it would be one of the big sensation in our Indian all states. While within going to the doctor, simply there is a small fee, 10 to 15 rupee, we are thinking to pet it the fee. In a 10 to 15 rupee, he can utilize 2 to 3 times doctor's feedback also. So live doctor would be not available over there. These all are AI integrated things over there. And slowly we are trying to integrate telemedicines also. So using the telemedicine, if people is looking for the guidance from the direct doctors also, we are giving that opportunity. So right now we are just connected with the SCPGI Lucknow and the BHU itself doctors. So they can also available how the things would be. They can interact directly with the patients also. So have look, this is a one demonstration. So whatever things I had stated within this one 50 second to 1 minute of video, you will able to understand what exactly in this one project we are trying to do.
Every year, 1.5 million people die from lung cancer. 3 people break a bone every second due to osteoporosis. These and many other medical conditions can be prevented if discovered early enough using CTs, X-rays, and MRIs. What if you could teach computers to provide faster, more accurate diagnosis based on the combined wisdom and experience of thousands of radiologists? Zebra Medical Vision introduces revolutionary technology based on advanced machine and deep learning. Thousands of previously diagnosed cases are uploaded to our analytics engine, teaching it to create unique algorithms that can identify the visual fingerprints of multiple diseases. Then, when shown a new scan, it instantly recognizes that fingerprint and alerts of the disease. Zebra Medical Vision is giving healthcare a breakthrough tool to help millions of people receive faster, more affordable quality care.
Fine. So whatever things I had got to discuss, yeah, definitely data is really very, very important. So using the deep learning analysis itself, we are trying to get the good predictions over there. And with that prediction, they are recommending the relative medicines also. So in this one, the entire concept which I was stating with you, sharing with you, hope after watching this one, a small video only, entire concept from scratch to end would be get clear with you. So while you are talking about the project itself, for example, you are applying to the DST, you are applying to the ICCMR, you are applying to the medical Ministry of Health itself. At that time, if you are going with such kind of presentation, definitely do believe me, when it will come to the evaluation round, they can give you more point. Yeah, because everything is a self-explanatory over there also. So if you're talking about the immersive technology benefits, so first is the higher engagement rate. Experiential learning, say for a hard situation, because right now again COVID situation, don't require to go out, reduce training and a travel expense. One time very big investment is required, but while lab is developed, definitely it could be carry on forward later on also. High retention rate. Why? Because we are keeping the headset here and we are not able to watch what's happening into the open environment also. So the full concentration, whatever you are playing, whatever you are giving the data to the audience or the learner, so engagement would be close to the 100% itself. Even we are integrated into the engineering also. Here you can see using the VR headset, right? He is operating with a sensor and he is operating the human body. So how the scar would have to create. So somehow when definitely after going such kind of training, he will go to the operating theater, definitely his hand would not be get taken down. Why? Because he having a prior idea, and if some problem is happening, definitely the error will start coming. Okay, you had a draw, but a wrong seizure, something errors, each and everything. So while using the game, you can say this is a games only. Exactly, this is like a game. While you are operating with a interacting with a 3D body itself, so you have to score 100 out of 100. If you are getting 1 point failure also, you are not a good medical practitioner. You need to do more practice over there, right? So with respect to the medical, I'm giving more examples. Like here you can see, this is the mixed reality. This is a Microsoft HoloLens 2 itself. So you can get interact with using a headset, controllers, and innovative technology. It's possible to navigate human anatomy through virtual and mixed reality. These realities can provide medical training and procedures, techniques, and equipment use, as well as simulate patient interactions in a more immersive and realistic way. As the VR-MR trend grows, pilot programs involving these technologies for the education of medical students are being implemented worldwide. Though not a replacement for hands-on practice, virtual and mixed reality are increasing situational experience. Giving students an opportunity to practice with computer simulation is a low-risk alternative and, in extreme cases, can prevent patient harm. The technology's new applications have many dubbing virtual and mixed reality a new reality. Fine, so this is you can say how into the medical we can get implement specifically the virtual reality itself, or you can say the gamifications over there. Now, especially if you're talking about the 21st century of research, where AI, artificial intelligence, deep learning, 3D printing, one more digital humans also came to the ICT integrated teaching and learning. Digital human also, what exactly where we are integrating CGI integrated characters to the real life teaching. For example, right now I'm here, some of the professor like Einstein is not now with us, but if we want, Einstein is teaching to the learner, so that is what required. Definitely we can't ask them to Lord Shiva or maybe to get back Einstein here on the floor itself. So what alternative we have? We can create an entire Einstein character into the 3D CGI itself. So digital human means what? Computer graphics integration. Now we are putting each and every pores. For example, in our hand, there is a one hairs also, the bended condition. We are creating that kind of minute detail also while we are creating the digital humans. So for digital humans also, we can go with the scanning technology also. Second, we can manually create an entire human using the Maya or Max application itself. Later on, we are putting the sculpting into the ZBrush or the Modbus applications. And then we can replace a real body with a digital human. I'm giving you some examples to get understand more effectively about the same.
Hi, I'm a fully simulated artificial representation capable of being driven and rendered.
So here you can check it out. These are the mesh. This one technically called the mesh itself. So this is not a real human. This is a CGI integrated simulated. So whatever I'm talking accordingly, this is performance over here, right? So have look earlier, we are using this terminology for movies or films, Hollywood movies, Bollywood movies also, Tollywood movies also, but right now into the teaching and learning also, the concept of a holographic, we are implementing here also. So this is one example which you can see.
Over the last couple of years, we've digitized me. I've got a digital avatar that looks pretty close to what I look like. And it runs in real time, not just...
So how the real life environment phase we are changing, like here you can see how the performance is going backside, according to 3D element is also changing the positions itself.
I'm the director of a digital human group with a team of engineers and authors.
So commonly the digital domain is dedicatedly for the VFX industry only, like if you're watching the movie Avatar, if you're watching the movie Avengers series, Marvel series itself, digital domain play a really very vital role to creating the CGI integrated real life characters also itself over there, right? So but now teaching and learning, now here you can see all the details, course here we are creating in detail, see depth, everything. So earlier, like you can see this one, a character, if you are a movie lover itself, Thanos character itself, this one, right? So these all things we are implementing into the CGI. Now I'm giving you one more detailed example, how this is somehow looking a little less realistic, right? Because this one content, I think 2016 or 17 game development conference, this has been get presented itself. I'm moving to the next to get more detailed digital human examples.
Hello, here I'm you can Simon. See. Hello, I'm Simon, and I'm a digital human. I was created by an international team of artists and engineers who wanted to challenge our ideas of what a synthetic human could be. I put state-of-the-art real-time graphics and an unprecedented level of detail in my eyes, skin, and hair. Cool, right? But I'm more than just a collection of fancy pixels. I'm actually being driven by a real human actress and her dynamic motion captures through Unreal Engine.
Fine. So here, this one video when you're watching, this is looking like a super realistic. All the details, pose, starts, whatever has been get put it out, all the wrinkles, what are coming over here. Each and every detail we had put it over there, no any misplaced. So now definitely computer graphics, we are integrating into the all field itself. Majorly, we are integrated computer graphics integrations with the medical science only, right? So hope these are the some examples you're having now much idea. These are the some more interactively, like using the sensors, or you can say that this one integrated with HTC Vive handset. So using the HTC Vive, how the face is going to be cut accordingly, you can push it out, you can drag, check it out. So this one entire practice using the head mounted display and VR sensors, or you can say the VR devices people can do, right? If we're talking about a VR again, some challenges is also over there. Users, design, and scalability. If you're talking about the scalability, definitely, for example, if you are creating any element, any character, and suddenly after completion of the project, or you can say the converting to the EXE, some again changes required, then for that, what is the requirement over there? Just a minute, one. Sorry, some electricity fluctuation here. So user design scalability. Second, the deliverability, efficiency, network connectivity issues, security, update changes into the existing experiment. So what these are, I'm commonly collecting all these bullet points at once. For example, if we're talking about a virtual reality, latency one keyword, which I had stated earlier. In India, if we are teaching the student using the online or the VR integrated things, even for our normal Zoom classes, sometimes learners are facing our issue, their video not working, internet slow. So definitely in India right now, this is a challenge. So that's why I had to put it one small star over there. Deliverability efficiency. Definitely if you're talking about this one industry, very few people are working into this one industry, specifically in India. Scalability, when the job is done and you have to add on, put it same thing, again, you have to go back. It's not like that when job is done. In between, you can put after the completion of the data also, because in a 3D, you have to create each and everything from scratch, right? Then security and adaptability. Definitely, if you're talking about the security in terms of our devices, a hardware assets. So we need to properly having a proper secure a laboratory for that, because devices are too much expensive. Then update changes to existing experiment. Like I had to tell you, if you have to update anything, for example, whatever we had created, the entire human model, and later on the people said, no, I'm looking for not a male body, I'm looking for the female body, 3D. Then again, we need to create the entire thing from the scratch. Or we are looking for the animal character. So for animal, we need to again create an animal body from the scratch only. These are some challenges over there, right? So each and every technology having the pros and cons. So if you're talking about overall concluding this one remark, then we will switch to some of the practical demonstration. So if we are integrating this one virtual reality, especially into the medical field itself, end of the day, it would be a new era of revolution into the medical education. While learners, while medical practitioners will be the more confident to do the simulations, to do the operation while they are going to the operation theater itself. Now, if you're talking about the next generation university, commonly in our mind, Stanford University, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, Oxford, Harvard is only coming. But here, just I had put in one of the university name, Case Western Reserve University, established in 1926. Maybe I do believe no one has heard about this one university name, if I'm not wrong. If someone has heard, make me apologize, right? But I do believe definitely no one has heard about this one university name. But still, during the COVID-19, how they had integrated their teaching and learning effectively, you would be really very, after watching this one small video, you would be also having more confidence if you are integrating this one device, the system in your laboratory. End of the day, learner engagement ratio would be get have increased itself. Just I'm playing the same. For example, I clearly remember when I started working into the ICT integrated teaching and learning, online teaching and learning in 2017, when I had delivered one course for SWAYAM NPTEL itself. At that time, people are saying online learning, how it could be really very effective and efficient. Definitely, end of the day, my perception, if we are planning our classes perfectly, and if we are integrating the technology into teaching and learning, especially virtual reality integrated devices, I have confidence. And after watching this one, visuals also today, this discussions also, you are also more confident. Even we are into the COVID-19 pandemic situations also, but if our university college is giving the proper infrastructure to the students also, we having a proper that kind of devices, and we are well versed into that, do believe me, either we are sitting at home or the college or the university, end of the day, learner engagement ratio would not fallen down, and end of the day, your result would be also more positive. But yeah, for that, again, it's a very big, you can say, a huge investment requirement is over there. Like, these are some of the recommendation which, for my virtual laboratory, we had get it developed, like NVIDIA RTX A600 graphics card for a simulation, and NVIDIA DGX system is also required to get high computation at once. This one, a size of box is like this one size only. But yeah, it would be on average Indian currency 1.5 CR of one GPU. It's not CPU. GPU integrated technology, which we are using especially for the virtualization, and this one are really very helpful, especially if you're talking about the deep learning, if you're talking about a calculation, a huge heavy data simulation itself also. So all GPU are working parallelly to get execute the data, right? So this is one of the infrastructure recommendation from my side. And if you want to get explore, know more about the immersive design visualization, very few books you can have identify. One is the Pearson publication, and second is the Springer Nature publication. One, you can go with a Design Immersive 3D Experience by Rennie Stevens itself. And second, you can go with the Immersive 3D Design Visualizations. This one book has been get written by me last year, January 2021 only. This one will get published in Springer. So this is an authored book. So very few books you having into the Immersive Design Visualizations right now. But you can explore, go with these both books if you want to get learn about Immersive Design Visualizations little more. And for example, if you want to get it learned more depth, how the 3D things will happen, for that also I'm giving you example. And also I'm right now working for one of the course, this one a long time back, 1.5 year back I had got started this one course, but still more development, more input I'm putting, because I'm looking this one course would be the one of the benchmark for pan India, like it could be the self-explanatory entire system. So this one of the course I'm developing for the virtual reality, and whatever right now I had stated, I have discussed with you. This video will give you the conclusion, what exactly today I had discussed, After that, we will start the application software. On that software, I will little guide you. Like, for example, the entire body, the molecules, we all things have been getting created in a video. But how this can be done? This is the one very big question in your mind. So definitely for that also, I had saved around last 45 minutes of time to get demonstrate practically about how the 3D element you can get create using the 3D applications also. So have looked this one of the short visuals has been get created and captured by me only to get entire clear concept about the virtual reality, game technology, and animation design, how can be beneficial for the medical education specifically. Sorry.
Hello everyone, welcome to the Podacity Nano Degree Program. I'm your mentor, Dr. Abhishek Giri, Assistant Professor at Department of Computer Science, Institute of Science, Banaras University. I'm Autodesk certified, Adobe certified, as well as the Apple certified also. And today, I will teach you about the NLP-oriented course on virtual reality. This course covers all the steps required to create a student with the help of Autodesk Maya and Unity to deploy it as a virtual reality team. This course, we will learn about the game asset design with the help of Autodesk Maya and Unity. As we all know that one of the hottest technologies in the current era is virtual reality, augmented reality, and the mixed reality. Let's start up. You may hear that technology as an AR, VR, or MR. So what this technology is? In general, we may not be able to go to Mars or some other planet and stay with the dolphin or shark, etc. But with that of virtual reality, VR, augmented reality, AR, and the mixed reality, MR, it promises that we may be able to interact with your things within going outside of your home. The technology promises to give you the feel of real world using the high performance computers and the necessary equipment like headsets, gloves, etc. Apart from games and the entertainment, it has long been used for training airline pilots and the further for helping the scientists to figure out the complex problem. What is your identity? Yeah, technology. But the interest in this technology has been formed since 2015 when the gamers and the handful scientists introduced the several high quality, relatively inexpensive commercial headsets to the public. A similar surge has emerged in augmented reality AR, a technology that uses to see through visors or the smartphone screen to real objects on top of real technology. The recent appearance of low-cost virtual reality technology like the Oculus Rift, the HTC Vive, and the Sony PlayStation VR, and the mixed reality interfaces, MRTF, like HoloLens, the suggesting that it may be the next dark stepping stone into the technological situation. The study of VR initiated into the computer graphics field and has been extended to the several disciplines. The computer graphics concept onto the VR technology could be the trend at the mid of 1960s, when the team on the land in a managed trip designed to design VR virtual reality as a window through which users would see the virtual world as it looked, felt, sounded real, and in this, the user could have reality and feel reality also. Today is the virtual reality VR technology is applied to the advanced field of medicine, engineering, education, design, training, entertainment, etc. Where is the computer interface designed to mimic the real world beyond the black monitor to give us the most 3D, three-dimensional visual experience? This is the first foundation level course focusing on the creation of requirement of virtual reality using the Unity 3D and Autodesk Maya application that's payable on headsets as well as on white devices with is a project abroad.
So this is about the course weekly inputs. So hope whatever things today I had, I got demonstrated about the virtual reality, VR itself, from scratch to end. Now your concept of a VR would be get clear and how it can be get implemented into the science, technology, engineering field, and especially into the medical itself. Right, so now it's a time for a small 5-minute question and answer. Then we will start the practical demonstration, how like this one, a software or interface is working. So little glimpses I will give with you. So meanwhile, if you're having any question related to right now, whatever we had to get presented, we can get discussed, or first we can get switched to the application, get know about the application little more, and then again we can go with a question answer round. So whatever the comfort zone for the respective professors and the researcher, we can go ahead. Meanwhile, I'm just switching to the application because we're having a limited time also. So any having any one question, meanwhile, you can type into the chat box also. So for that, like in our visuals also, we had a get demonstrated, either we can use the Autodesk Maya application, Max application for integrations of virtual reality. We can go with a Unity game engine, as well as we have in Unreal game engine also. So these are the applications, these are the softwares we can get utilized to get create a such kind of element. Now you may having one question, Autodesk Maya, from where it will come, how we can get access this one application. Don't worry about that. For that also, I'm giving one of the URL link. So that will help you to get this one application at free of cost without paying a single penny itself for 1 year. Okay, so this one application I opened. Any question, meanwhile, you can type to the chat box also. I'm parallelly watching the all three screens. I had a connector right now. Okay, sure, sentiment analysis. I'm giving you one example, Harjeet Singh. Wait. So for how you can get access about the application software, you can go to the Google simply and type AUTODESK student or teacher version. Right, so here you have in the first URL, and type into the chat box also. Here you can get login yourself. Okay, my account is login. Just simply I'm doing logout. I'm doing sign in again. Fine. So when you will do sign in, meanwhile, in between, when you first time register yourself here, they will ask about your university institute ID card. Then only they will give you the free access for 1 year, right? With unlimited support also. Now we can go scroll down here. Now here you can see several people having confusion, like maybe some of the people from the background of civil engineering, right? So we having the AutoCAD applications, AutoCAD for Mac, Maya, Alias, Arnold, Civil 3D, right? These are all applications available free of cost. Don't go ahead and use the unlicensed versions of software. I will always recommend you all the applications is available free of cost by Autodesk itself. So go with the original license, educator, teacher versions itself, right? These are all the applications we having a list, very big list. So let us go to the Autodesk Maya here. Simply you will hit into the get started, right? So again, they will ask about your detail. And now here you can having access about the three applications, get Autodesk software. Again, now here I'm hitting the get product. So now here you can get check it out, March 2018-19-2022. English, Chinese, Japanese versions we have in Windows, Mac, Linux versions we have in. So you can get install and download from here. Parallelly, I had a little first time demonstrated about the same. I'm giving you one URL link also, Maya for students. Okay, I had a pre-recorded one video also. Just wait for a while. I'm putting to the chat box. So one of the pre-recorded video also I had a get captured long time back. This is a complete whatever I had a demonstrated how you can get install MAR 2017 to 20 version free of cost, install and run, right? So you can go ahead with this one URL also. If you're having any problem, this is a self-explanatory video, how to get access to the application free of cost. Get it? So now coming to the software. Close it. So my screen is hope visible with everyone. So when you open the Autodesk My application in such way, you having an interface will come with you, right? Right now we had done the Java programming, Python programming. So now from last 2 years, we can also able to see this one a gray color of background. Technically, if you're talking about the graphic design visualizations itself, while the background color is gray, your eye cornea, while you are working long 10 to 15 hours rigorously also onto the computer also, no? This one color will not make you more stressed. That's why gray color concept into the computer graphics applications we are all using long time back, but now in a programming IDE also, now application development industry is also preferring the gray color of background only, because that will give you the less stress. While you open the application, such kind of interface you may able to see here. This is the perspective view, 3D view itself, right? When you hit the spacebar button from the keyboard, spacebar, it would be get it maximize, minimize itself, right? Top view, spacebar, in which viewport you will keep your mouse, that would be maximize or minimize. One thing you have to keep in your mind, while you are working into the any computer graphics integrated application, you should be having three mouse button itself. One, second, three. So this one, the scroll purpose, and when you can hit, it would be work like a button also, right? So this one of three mouse MMB button is required over there. So what are use of these three buttons? I'm giving you a small example. Let us start with a small example. I had created one of the simple start box. Let us create one different shape. Okay, pen drive shape. This could be some small chemistry, one of the element itself also. Okay, so now here how to get interact with the viewport. First of all, we have to keep two, three buttons in our mind. Alt button, right? And left mouse button. You have to hit the Alt button and left mouse button. And simply you can get the scroll down. So what will happen? You can get navigate the perspective view of your object, right? When you use the Alt button and right mouse button, then you can do the zoom in, zoom out into the viewport, right? When you use the Alt button and middle mouse button, what you have to do? Press. Then if you can be pan here, right? So these are the three button concept you have to keep in your mind. Alt and LMB, Alt and MMB. Just I'm typing to the chat box. Alt plus LMB. Alt plus MMB. Alt plus RMB. These are the three keyboard button primary you have to keep in your mind to get navigate your viewport. Now, for example, if we want to scale it or move it or rotate it, so what are the shortcuts of a scale, rotate, move? You have to keep three button, Q, W, E, R. I had put it into the chat box also. Q, W, E, and last one is the R. So in a chat box, I had put it Q, W, E, R. Let us type to the notepad also. Q, W, E, R. So Q means selection. So for example, here I am hitting the Q button. So what happening, you can check it out in a viewport. When I put it the Q button, this one has been get changed to the selection. When I putting the W, it's a switching to the move option. When I'm putting E, it's a giving us the option of rotate. When I'm putting R, it's a giving us the options of scale itself. So you have to keep two things over there. One, the mouse controller, second is the keyboard controller, right? So let us create one small.
So
due to some network problem, Abhishek sir has left the meeting. He will be joining it soon. Participants, please wait.
Samriddhi, please drop the message to the sir in a WhatsApp.
Yes, ma'am. I have called him.
Hello, my voice is coming. Sorry about the interruptions.
No problem, sir.
Continuously going on. Can anyone tell me where this one has been get disconnected? So I will start from there only. Application was started. What is my application?
Sir, you told about QWER.
Okay. That means just disconnected around 2-3 minutes before only. Okay, I'm again assessment. I will see in just a minute. Thank you. Okay, so again, my screen may be visible. I carry forwarded here. Sorry for interruption. Fine. So now again, I think it's visible. Oh, by mistake, I think I had into the stop sharing or something. It may happen. Okay, fine. Coming back. So again, I'm deleting QWER for select, move, rotate, and scale. Now I'm going to create, for example, in a several movies, we are watching some of the, like you can say, the human body is formed, they are just fighting and they are playing kind of thing. So how you can create a 3D element? So that a basic shape is like a sphere over there. So when we're talking about the sphere, in a 3D applications, we can divide the any 3D element into four parts. First is the vertex, VRTX. Second, we can go with the ETGE. And third, we have in the face, and fourth we have in the object. So what these four elements are, slide is not here. Devika ma'am, there is no any slide. I had shared the direct screen only. So I think it's visible also in my third monitor. Please, any other participant can confirm?
Yes, it is visible, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Okay, so four components we have in vertex, face and object. So how, let us see into the application. I have selected this one object and right click here. You have to do the right click. So when you do the right click, now here you can see vertex, edge, object, and face. So what are the vertex? I'm choosing the vertex. So here you can see these are the points. So these points are known as vertex. So we can deform the 3D object using these points only. If you're talking about the computer graphics, our regular classes into the computer science engineering, simply we are teaching a student line drawing algorithm, circle drawing algorithm, how much complex we are like a simple for drawing one line. We have to go with a several mathematical equations, or you can say the expressions itself over there. But here you can see simply I had a click, an entire sphere has been getting drawn also over here, right? So I am moving. This is a vertex for deformation. Second, as I had tell you, edge. So when I'm choosing edge, so edge means what? When two vertex, when two points are connected with each other, that is known as the edge. So we can deform the object from the edge also. Third is what? Face. So we can select the face when minimum three points are connecting with each other, minimum three requirements, then only one face would be get generated. So these are the three component basics, vertex, edge, and face for any 3D element, computer graphics element itself. And then we have to select the entire object, then you have to right click and go to the object mode. So now you can move the entire object. Now, if we're talking about simple 3D elements, so at that time, there would be a small tail is required over there. So first of all, I'm just changing the rotation. We are rotating this one. right? So put the value 90 degree here. And what I record, I want one tail here. So for that, simply I'm going to the face. What you have to do, right click and face. And select this one area. Drag and select. But let us check it out. This one wrongly selected the back face also. So for selection and deselection, what you can do, you can again hit the control button from the keyboard. You can hit the control and drag. When you use the control and drag, it would be deselect. See here, control and drag, deselect. If you have to add, then you can use the shift and drag. When you use the shift and drag, it could be addition. So for addition, you can use the shift. For subtractions, you can use the control itself. So now this one area is now selected. Now what I required? The extrusions I required here. So let us shift this one. And now simply I am using the mesh here. In mesh, we have in the extrude option. So we can now extrude it here. And we can scale it here. We can more extrude it here. We can rotate little. We can little more extrude it here. Right, so in this manner we can get creative cells. Even for example, this one not exactly round, it would be little oval shape. So for that I am doing right click and vertex again. I am selecting one vertex here. And softly we have to get scale it. So for that, what options we have? We can use the B button. B for Bombay itself. When you hit the B button, here you can see soft selection mode is on. Now after hitting the B button, the you can little scale it. Now so here you can see the shape is whatever we required. Now shape has been generated. Okay. So this is how you can get create a 3D element into the 3D application, right? So first of all, we are creating the element into the 3D application. Later on, we are exporting this one data to where game engine, and then we can integrate that game engine data with what, like simulators itself. For that also, I will share you one of the flowchart also that will give you a really very clear idea how the VR methodology is going ahead for the medical practitioner. Okay, for example, now I required a multiple replica for the scene. So for that, I'm switching modeling to the effects. Here we having one option, mesh. So I'm using create a mesh network, right? So mesh is the one of the, you can say the simulation options in Autodesk Maya itself, which using which we can create a multiple replica, multiple copy. So I'm using the create mesh network. When I hit into the create mesh network, here you can see the multiple copy has been getting generated. But now what I required, I want to get it play the irregular distribution systems. So for that, what you have to do, we have to hit into the mesh editor, right? When you use the mesh editor, now here you can just check it out. Mesh editor window is now open. Okay. So here we having the option mesh distribute, mesh one tab and mesh repro itself. So I'm going to the mass distribute. Here how many points? 10 points. You can increase, decrease from here. Now distribution type is what? Here you can see the linear. You can get check it out to the radial. Okay. You can get change to the spherical. This is regular. You can get change to the mesh. Mesh means if any particularly 3D object, if we are creating on that surface, if we want to use the object, then we can use the mesh. For example, I am creating one of the torus, and I want the on the surface of torus, this should be get like a snap. Then again, I am going to the mesh network, right? Mesh distribute, and here I have to choose the mesh. And here the option input mesh. Input mesh is vacant. So simply from here, you can drag the torus. Again, it's a change the tab 1 minute to the input mesh. Now see what happened. The entire DNA has been get, not DNA, you can say the small objects. And when job done, let us hire it. So see now what happened. This one get aligned with the particularly that torus shape itself. I'm doing undo. Fine. So now the fundamental of mesh is now also clear with you. So you can get wrapped into any mesh, any other objects also. So these are the way of distribution systems. we can literally switch up. Grid also, so entire grid here, this is a grid point. This one copied into the grid. Okay, I'm doing the Y copy grid. So hope now you're having a clear idea, a little idea how the mesh distribution can be done. For example, now I want an irregularity here. For example, I'm choosing the radial or a spherical. Okay. Now what I want to add some animations here, right? Motions here. So for that, we're having a multiple options here. So again, I'm going to the mesh, right? So here we having some options like a flight, like we having the signal. So let us add the signal node here. So when I'm hitting the signal node, add signal node here, then what happened here, you can see into the outliner. Now we're having the signal node again. So in a signal node, we're having a multiple options, position, rotation, right? So here the position is X, Y, Z. So now I'm just can play with the value here. Now signal type is what? 14 wise. We want trigonometry. So it can go in a trigonometry node, right? When you hit the play button here, now here you can see how beautifully it's starting simulated. Let us switch off the grid and let us save the background. Okay. Slow movement I want. See? Curl noise. The multiple types of noise we have in here. 4D noise. So it would be like front and back, front and back. More positions you want to disturb. Now it's looking like, okay, these are start playing the race going forward, right? We can get create a background over there. So it would be log type. It would be playing forward itself over there. So hope now you're having a little idea about the 3D applications also, how the things can be go ahead, right? So this is one of the small interface of Maya application. Now, maybe definitely one query in your brain right now, I had a quickly opened and something we had created. So this is a one small glimpse, like a commonly maximum what I had watched into the several faculty development program, ATEL itself also, AICT also itself. Just as a learner also, I had also attended some of the program over there. But how practically that is going to be done? That has somehow several times, due to less amount of time, as a learner, we are not able to understand. So one hitch is over there. Okay, a lot of things the professor has attested, but how exactly that would we get it done? So that a problem what I had a feeling. So I thought, okay, definitely there should be some practical demonstrations also. So you should be having also now a little idea how the things can be get it done. Okay, so more notes we having like trails. I'm using the trails over there, decay trails. Lot of things we having. Now here you can see the trails also, they are going to be created. Can we replace this with real? Yeah, definitely we can replace this one with the real images also. Even we can get a rapid, for example, I'm removing the undo, I'm doing the undo. For example, if you want to get wrap some of the color also here, right? So for that, I'm simply doing some additional new material. And I'm adding some colors over here. See, now the color has been get changed to the red color. When we can add some maps also here. So for that, what we have to do, add, right click, find new material. Any image, for example, I want a checker. So we having now checker images. So now here you can see the checker boxes are coming here. Fine. If you want to add some not checker images, some other image you want. So for that, you have to little learn about the applications also. So just I'm going to the, but the question is here. So you should be having the answer how the things can be getting done. So we are going to the Hypershade node itself. So here I'm deleting the checker here. And now as if we want some image here, I'm just switching to the Google. BLWDCLL T-E-X-T-U-R-A, right? Here I'm using one blood cell texture. Done. And what I want, this one blood cell texture should be here. So I'm going to the file and I'm projecting this one blood cell texture. It's into the download, I think. The users downloads. Date modified. We need to, yes. Fine. So now here you can get check it out. The texture is now with us. Got it. So we can add images also. Now here you can see. Got it. So the same manner now, whatever I had presented earlier, you having also now the idea how that things can be get it done. So now I think we having time for the question and answer round also. Now, okay, one more thing I had missed. Like I had stated, if you want to get to know more about how we can go with the virtual reality. So for the virtual reality, two components is required. How this one thing could be get it done. So just recently I was completing this one research paper I was working. This one research paper has been finally accepted into the Taylor and Francis CI journal 2.3 find impact factor. So how the medical simulations is going on. So first starting from the ideations and concept, then we do for the modeling, we are doing the model, then we are putting the color structure. If we are creating the human body, then we have required to put the bone structures over there. Then we are adding animation, then we are exporting to the game engine, then we are adding effects and simulation, then writing and rendering, then pre-game testing, then virtual reality integration, and at end, we are exporting the final application. So this is the entire flowchart. When we are talking about a gamification, we can say the virtual reality integrations, specifically for the medical industry also. I'm just checking where is the file. Yes. So this is the one paper which I was working. Just I'm scrolling down and some few labs also the same flowchart here you can see. The same flowchart we had to get implemented into the research also. And finally, this is our research one lab where we are doing all the testing. These are the HoloLens. We are doing the research with the Netex and all devices. And some of the feedback we had, I get to check it out. So this is how the medical industry, how we can get integrate the virtual reality itself. And now more thing, if you want to get it, learn more about the same, then you can go to the Swayam NPTEL website. And now admission has been get closed for this one semester, but when you hit into the ongoing enrollment and close here, you can get check it out the course here animations itself. So the entire data, how the model texture, animation model architecture, all the details, this is a prerequisite before going to the virtual reality simulation, right? So if you're having a well idea about the 3D assets, computer graphics integration, then only you can go to the virtual reality integration for the same. So for this one semester, this one course has been get closed. So again, if someone want to get learn more about the same, so yeah, this one went off. Enrollment ended on 31st August 2021 only. So next semester, again, you can go ahead to get it learned into more detail if someone is more interested about the same. So it's time to now question and answer round. So mic over to the host. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
I think.
Okay, sorry, sir. Yeah. Thank you very much, sir. On the behalf of Biomedical Engineering, IT, and NIT Raipur, I thank you so much for your lecture, giving us time for this STTP. Dr. Mridu, madam, is also there. Madam, you'd like to say something? Madam, you are mute. You have to unmute yourself.
Yes, sir. I attended your full lectures. I enjoyed a lot. Thank you for the great, most informative lecture, sir, from your side. Because you have mentioned the many things related to that healthcare, how we use the virtual reality in the current scenario. So I think participants enjoyed well your lecture, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, so now we have discussion part. So all the participants, they are requested to either post their questions in the chat box or they can ask also directly. So all of you are invited for questions.
Sir, one question from Harjeet Singh. He is asking how virtual reality can be used for sentiment analysis. Sir, your mic is
muted. Okay. If you're talking about the sentiment analysis, again, you have to go with a psychological, like a perspective, you have to get analysis. Commonly, what we can do, if you're having all the devices and sensors, you can then go with how the brain is reacting accordingly. But manually, at initial level, what you can do, you can create one of virtual reality online laboratory system, right? You can give to all of the participants, ask them to at least access the entire laboratory for 1 week. You should make a questionnaire with respect to that. In that questionnaire, we can put the sentiment analysis related how after watching, how much stress you are feeling. Maybe you had attended around 20 minutes regularly virtual reality integrated lab solution, because headache is a very common thing when we are going to the VR integrated systems over there for a long time, right? That's why still specifically if you're talking about the Stanford University and especially one of the integrated program with I'm missing the university name into the it's New Zealand itself. So both they are collaboratively working rather than keeping a headset over there as in a head mounted display. Let us convert the screen as an HMD features only. So if we are not keeping additional device over the head at that time, that could be more impactful. But again, at that time, what a problem will happen, because parallelly I'm also working with NSW University and South Korea University itself on the same project itself. But my feeling, my research are saying, if we are replacing head-mounted display with automatically on-screen presentation, the retention ratio would be get a little decreased. Why? Because when we are watching multiple elements on a screen, parallelly maybe someone is going right to left, left to right, at that time, the medical distraction, the human brain distractions would be over there. So the retention would be get less. So my point of view, if we are again keeping the head mounted display only for the virtual reality, end of the day, the retention, the result would be much better. So for sentiment analysis, again, we can go with the pedagogy with respect to the rubrics of the sentiment analysis. We can apply that rubric and with the quantitative analysis methodology only, we can go ahead. Again, if you check it out in China also, what they had done, they had implemented virtual reality using the sensor in the classroom. So for example, each and every student, they had given one of the like a simple one band over the head. So for example, when teacher are teaching the student, the kids, they had implemented into the pre-nursery only. So for example, if I'm talking about the earth itself, right, universe itself. So at that time, what happening, if a learner is not thinking about particularly that particular subject, he may right, left, shifting the head over. So the sensors is keeping, okay, now the learner is not focusing. So with respect to that, the seismograph kind of things, they had put it into the dashboard of the teacher, professors itself. So they are joking, okay, this one student are not actively participating. He are moving ahead right and left over there. That point, he is not engaging, he is not interested for the same. So somehow the sentiment, somehow the engagement ratio, they are calculating. But strictly, if you're talking about some specific sensors, still research is going on, and parallelly, I'm also working on the same. We are be like before implement some AI based system, how it would be look like? I'm not exactly understanding the question, Govind Swami, sir. We are maybe a prototype before we implement some AIB system, how it will be look like. Can you elaborate little two part exactly, or you can unmute yourself and you can ask your question. Because end of the day, VR is also artificial intelligence only. Computer graphics integrated. Yes, sir.
Sir, we have some kind of AI based system.
Okay.
So before that, we develop some kind of a prototype. So for which can we utilize this virtual reality?
Okay, sir. Sir, if you're talking about the virtual reality system, it's again artificial intelligence only, while we are interacting with a CGI element with real world, right? So if you're talking about AI, AI is a very broad field, sir. So if I have a like a talk about like a medical analysis, so using the deep learning, we had taken the data of all humans, then later on we had integrated into the prediction system, right? So if we're talking about the VR into the regular teaching, regular analysis system, at that time, first of all, we need to a complete setup of VR integrated laboratory where at least we're having a 10 to 15 headsets over there. If you're talking about the prototype, if you're talking about specifically, then majorly hardware is only responsible over here. So without hardware, if you're talking about, for example, how the engagement, because using the animated videos also, we are somehow interacting with the same, but animated video is only, you can say, ICT integration, multimedia integration into the teaching and learning. But while we are talking about the learn by doing practice, LBD, at that time, using the video and multimedia presentation, LBD can't be done. So for that, we having integrate either AR. So in AR, at initial, you can go with the AR because in AR, we having not required of VR headset. Simply, we can have to create an entire 3D element using the application. Either we can use the Maya integration with Unity or using the Unreal Game Engine. Then that EXE we can get developed. That could be playable for the Android as well as the iOS. And that how the effectively player are playing. So at initial, we can start with the AR, sir. Then we can integrate to the virtual reality system and mixed reality system, sir. This is my slowly, step by step, how we can get integrate ourselves to the AR to VR to MR to XR itself. How, Ranjit, sir, one question, how we can use VR into the regular teaching process? Like, sir, one of the visuals also I have shared, like right now, COVID-19 pandemic time, all the laboratory has been getting closed itself. While I had just shared one of the video of the Western University itself. So what they had did, the professor had created entire VR stimulation system in their own place. And second-hand side also, all the learner, even they are at their home only, they had kept the same headset. So whatever we are presenting using that head-mounted display, they are also able to watch the same thing. How I'm interacting, learners can also interact. But again, as you had said, seen over there, they had a deliver HMD, head-mounted display, Microsoft HoloLens 2 to each and every learners also to their home. So for example, if that kind of infrastructure we are developing, like several private universities, several, like we can say the IITs, specifically IIT Hyderabad, they having a right now DGX 100, what the CPU I am telling about you with everyone. So we should be having that kind of infrastructure also to get implement. Then for that, again, we should be a seek a fund from the government or the trustee or the investor also itself. So slowly it would be get it implemented. Like I tell you, sir, at initial, if we are going to implement VR into the regular teaching, we require a lot of infrastructure, huge of money required, even one headset. Minimum, if you go with an Oculus Rift also, that would be on average 50,000. So for example, commonly, yeah, if we're talking about private institutions, we are a fee more than 10 to 15 lakh rupee, maybe university or institute can afford one headset to their students, to them over, right? But if we're talking about the government universities, while the fees are very less over there, how we can each and individually deliver the headsets to their students. So it's a little tough. So in person, if we're talking about the student also, purchasing the same assets and stuff. So in that case, what is the options we're having? As in a university, we can put a requisition to the Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, over there, this kind of setup we want. So for that, we are seeking some of the funds, some of the grant. So we can develop the virtual reality, one of the setup, one of the laboratory in the university or institute. So then that could be slowly get integrated into the regular teaching and learning process also, sir. It will take time.
Thank you, sir, for nice information.
Sure, sir. Thank you, sir. So I'm just writing the email ID, abhsakrylbhu@gmail.com. So this is a one of email ID which I can be connectable, right? So further any more question? And even later on also, you can put the query to the email ID also. So I will try to get resolve the query within 48 hours itself. So I think no. Okay, thanks Mridul ma'am and Vikesh Singh sir to giving me opportunity to share my some small knowledge, because definitely each and every day as an learner, as an a professor, we are learning, because it's a regular process. Even commonly still, if I'm talking about myself also, on average every day I'm giving minimum 3 to 4 hours time to get integrate, to get explore something new, because as an a professor, if we are talking about our roles and responsibility, we are only responsible for change the nation, change the youth, and if we are not upgrading ourselves, definitely our students are now more active. Simply before coming to the class, they are going to the Google, they are downloading a lot of data, and they are coming to the college, and randomly sometimes when they are not in mood to get learned, they are asking some random question, throwing the ball to the teacher court over there. So we should be also get it upgrade each and every day with respect to the youth only. Earlier time, okay, we are giving some of the notepad, okay, these are the recommended books, learn from the book, come to the class. But now technology has been rapidly changing, so we should be upgrading ourselves day by day also. Thanks a lot, NIT Raipur, to giving me opportunity to sharing my thoughts, sharing my knowledge to one of the national platform. Thanks professors, thanks researchers, Pram India, to listen me, because while I'm taking the figure 101, 102, 101 is part of six over there, so hope somehow I'm able to convey my knowledge to all of you. Still any query, any confusion, I'm available with you. So thanks again. Thanks, ma'am. Mic's over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Vikesh, sir, kindly conclude the session. Yeah, Vikesh, sir, is there? Yeah, Priyanka, kindly conclude the session, beta.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much, sir, for giving your valuable time. I hope students have gained a lot from you. And yes, sir, please.
Yeah, thanks, ma'am. So thanks for the same. So I think next session also may be scheduled back to back.
Yes,
so
yes,
definitely.
Yes, yeah. Sir, we are ending with the session now. Thank you, sir. And our next session will start by 12:45. Participants, you can take 5 minutes break.
Okay. Thanks, ma'am. So may I leave, ma'am?
Thank you, sir.
Have a good day, ma'am.
Thank you. Really, it's a very wonderful lecture here.
Thanks, ma'am, and have a good day to all of you, and be safe, because yes, we have to do a lot of things in next 10 to 15 years to make our country on more greater heights. Thank you, all of you. Have a great day.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much. Good day.